Hello, you magnificent bastards. I am Dr. Layman, and I am drunk. Yeah, that's not a good start to a video now, is it? Right, one of my subscribers and patrons, Rust Castle, suggested this as a video topic for me, academic rigor. And I did have a few recordings prior to this that were scripted, and they did not go well. I just became increasingly frustrated, increasingly drunk, and yada yada, one led to the other, and now I'm doing an unscripted recording. Just, you know, see what happens. Maybe it will be fucking amazing. Let's talk about academic rigor. Before anything, I think I need to really establish one thing. I think I'm a hypocrite. You know, on the one hand, I condemn that Muslim communities in Europe do not distance themselves from terrorism. On the other hand, I do not distance myself from faulty social research. And I think that is a tremendous issue that does make me a hypocrite. And if I look back through the history of my channel, then yeah, I definitely did not distance myself enough from faulty ideological research. And I think even the term research is, it's insulting if you apply that to some of the papers that have been published recently. So let's talk about what we can do in this regard. And I think the topic suggested, academic rigor, fits this perfectly. Most of the issues that we have nowadays in social research are based on this one fundamental misunderstanding of social sciences or social research. And that's, it's easy. People who start out in the field often have this idea that, you know, phew, who even gives a fuck? I'm just gonna write my own opinion. I'm gonna be basically a glorified blogger. And I think that is absolutely disgusting. That is absolutely disgraceful. Like, I don't want you cunts in my fucking field. Just leave. During one of my earlier recordings, I called them cancerous. And yes, they are cancerous, but I don't mean it as an insult. I mean it as a almost medical comparison. They too start out small, you know, in their fucking ideology-driven publishers who basically enable this kind of behavior in the first place. And then slowly but steadily, they spread and infect everything. We've seen this in history, in political science, in communication science, sociology, economy. We've seen this fucking everywhere. And all of this can be traced to this one fundamental misunderstanding that since it's not a natural science, you can do whatever the fuck you want. And no, you can't. If you start putting yourself in the research that you're conducting, and worst of all, if you allow your own value judgments to tamper with the data, then you are not a researcher, but you are a blogger. That is your opinion. That has nothing to do with research. So yeah, I'm just gonna reiterate that I'm completely distancing myself from those people. To get back to this idea of it being easy or not being easy, since you are working with phenomena that are very hard to establish on an objective basis, since you are dealing with phenomena that change throughout history and they change increasingly faster, and since you are dealing with methods that are 100 to 200 years old and are not all that refined, you absolutely have to apply far more academic rigor to your research than you would do in other fields. You have to look at where does your funding come from, because funding can have a tremendous impact on your results. If you are being privately funded, then you are very likely to basically give the opinion that your sponsor wants and not give an honest academic opinion. You have to look at your own cultural background. If you are a radical Muslim, then your analysis will be very much different to the analysis of a radical Christian. And most of all, you have to read conflicting literature. And I think that is one of the most often ignored points, essentially. People just read literature that supports their viewpoint, but they completely reject any kind of literature that goes against it. But from my personal experience, just a tiny drop of conflicting literature can lead to tremendously better understanding of the issue at hand. So just those three points, funding, culture, conflicting literature, which are a tiny speck of all this stuff you have to keep in mind, just those three points would already increase the quality of the work you are providing. And I think that's my basic message in this video. We need to take a step back and re-examine all of the fields that have issues. I have made a video on why I disagree with Sargon of Akkad's petition, and people have called me, you know, an SJW cuck and supporting social justice, but I do not support social justice. I think, honestly, I'm far more against it than Sargon could ever be. But this issue has to be solved within the research community. So what I'm advocating for is take a step back, take a deep breath, and get back to the basics. It was Max Weber himself who said, "Causal analysis provides absolutely no value judgments, and a value judgment is absolutely not a causal explanation." Remove any kind of value judgments from your research. Remove any kind of personal opinion, personal ideas from research, and become as impartial as humanly possible. That means that if I were presented with the opportunity to do some research on feminism, then yes, I would completely ignore any kind of opinion I have on feminism. I would definitely start out by reading literature that is very conflicting to my own viewpoints. I would read feminist classics, I would read radical feminist Marxist literature, and just about anything that might just might change my viewpoint, because that's what it's all about. And after you've gotten back to the basics, removed your value judgments, and, you know, read up on conflicting literature, then we can talk. I think this entire conflict stems from this one fundamental misunderstanding, that people think it's easy because it's so diffuse and complicated. But if anything, because the fields are so complicated, so complex, so nebulous, so changing, you should apply far more rigor than you normally would. I'm Dr. Lehmann, glad you tuned in, and as always, Babylon prevails.